Welcome back to the Pokémon Platinum walkthrough. In the last part, we defeated Gym Leader Candace in the Snowpoint Gym, and in this part, we will join up with Barry at Lake Acuity. Now that we can use Rock Climb outside of battle, I will teach Rock Climb to Torterra. It's not necessary to use an HM Slay for Rock Climb, since it's a good normal type move. Its base power is 90, slightly stronger than Strength, but with a little less accuracy. Rock Climb can also confuse the target from time to time. Once you have a Pokémon with Rock Climb, you can head over to the Acuity Lakefront. Climb up the rock wall to get to the plateau where the entrance to Lake Acuity is. If you head to the right, you can pick up a Reaper Cloth. If you trade a Dusk Clubs while it's holding a Reaper Cloth, you can evolve it into a Dusk Noir. When you get to Lake Acuity, you will find that Jupiter has already defeated Barry's Pokémon. Both Jupiter and Barry will leave after a while, and Jupiter hints that your next destination is the Galactic HQ in Veilstone City. If you surf over to the northeast corner of the lake, you can pick up TM40 in Blizzard, and I will teach that to my Golduck. Blizzard is the most powerful ice-type move in the game, and it's only matched by Avalanche when its power is boosted. If you use Blizzard when it's hailing, its accuracy will be 100%. If you want to, you can now head to the Galactic HQ in Veilstone City to take on Team Galactic. I will postpone that for a while to do some exploring now that we have Rock Climb. If you head back to Route 216 near the rest house, you can climb up the rock wall and find some trainers that were previously inaccessible. On the far right of this plateau, you can pick up Team 13 Ice Beam. I will teach this move also to my Golduck. Although Ice Beam is only the second most powerful Ice-type move, it is more reliable and has more PP. It is therefore a more natural choice for many players. There are more areas in Sinnoh to explore with Rock Climb, and also a few areas where you can use Surf that I unfortunately forgot earlier. We will now go through them all. In the Ravaged Path on Route 204, you can head to the left and smash the rock to gain access to an area where you can use Surf. Surf upwards as far as you can go, where you can pick up TM03 Water Pulse. Once you have done that, you can follow the path on the left side, smash the rocks and pick up a Luck Incense. In Eterna City, you can pick up a hidden moonstone by surfing across a small lake in the northeast corner of the city. On Route 208, you can head down to the river and climb up the rock wall to battle a hiker. On the northern part of Route 210, up the stairs above the Ace Duo, you can climb down the rock wall and climb up another wall to battle a Dragon Tamer. While you are here, be sure to pick up a Zinc to the right of the trainer, and a hidden shiny stone to the left of the trainer, and down a small set of stairs. Inside this house is Grandma Wilma, and she will teach your Dragon-type Pokémon the powerful move Draco Meteor if its friendship is maxed out. On Route 211, west of Celestic Town, you can climb up the rock wall and pick up Team 29 Psychic and a Calcium. In Veilstone City, you can climb up onto a ledge to the right of the gym and pick up a full incense. At the Hotel Grand Lake, you can use Rock Climb next to the house with a Game Freak member, and eventually you will reach a ledge where you can pick up an Iron and Team 85 Dream Eater. In the southeast part of the area, you can use Rock Climb to obtain a protein and a hidden sunstone. If you climb up the wall on the west side of Route 213, you can pick up Team 05 Roar and a hidden HP up. In the next part, we will explore the ocean routes to the south of Sand Gem Town.